Hello everyone. So there's a reason why in all of my other video guides etc. I usually just put the notes, and by now you've probably already guessed it. Since I'm not a native English speaker, and I bet that right now your ears are bleeding, probably. So sorry about that. I've watched the last trailer of Bruma, which is an official DLC sized mod, and I decided to get back in Skyrim. It's been, I think, like almost a year after the last time that I played. So I decided, you know what, let's make a new character play again. So this is the first time that I'm going to make a gameplay with me commenting. So again, as I said, I'm probably making your ears bleed. So I'm trying to improve my English, so any kind of correction is appreciated. Just please don't be Nazis about that. And well, I guess we can get started. So let's not waste any more time with this intro. Okay, so this about this character. I went with a Breton for reasons, and I guess we can talk about that later. Anyway, moving into first person. So I'm using right now the alternate start, which is a mod obviously,
Approach, my child, and choose where your new life shall begin.
but I think that I'm going to use the regular start, because with the special edition of Skyrim and the game coming on Switch as well later, there should be some new player, no, new players, not that much, but I think some. And I'm going with the regular start because I want to show a couple of tricks that you can do during the tutorial. So maybe in the future, if I'm going, sorry, if I'm going to make a new, let's play with other characters, then I'm going to go with different stars. There are a few of them, so it can be interesting.
Such is the strange and twisted hand of fate.
Anyway, I think that you already, let's say that I'm already showing up, that I'm, what's the right term? A noob? A novice about all this commentary thing. For a second, I thought that the game was just gonna crash on me. I spent like the last few days removing and adding mods, trying to fix pretty much everything, since it was a mess before. Okay, so regular intro. I think you know the drill by now. I mean, probably most people have played the game already, so they know how it all starts. Man, did it take so much for them to speak?
Hey, you. You're finally awake. You were trying to cross the border, right? You walked right into that Imperial ambush, same as us, and that thief over there.
Damn you, Stormcloaks. Skyrim was fine until you came
Okay,
along.
so I don't know
Empire
if
was
I
nice
should
and lazy.
speak over
Had me
them,
looking for you.
or
Stolen that
after all
horse
there
and
are
been
the
halfway to
subtitles
Emmerfell.
anyway, or if that bothers people, so I don't know, let me know in the comments about that. I think that everyone saw this scene, so I'm going to take this time to explain a couple of things. As I said, this charter is Breton. They have a native 25% resistance to magic, which is always useful, especially on higher difficulties. And more importantly, they have their dragon skin ability, which gives them 50% of spell absorption. And I'm not going to waste time explaining all the stuff that spell absorption affects. But I'm just gonna say that I'm going to use that for a couple of tricks with this build. Nothing too overcomplicated, but kinda want to use this character to test a bunch of stuff. And speaking of playstyle, I'm kinda trying to make a Jack of all trades, Master of None character, so it's gonna be a bit of a mix. Hopefully it's not gonna suck, because that's kinda happen when you don't specialize. But luckily for us, after the release of the official DLC, with, I think it was with Dragonborn, that they made... they introduced a way to basically, how do you say that in English? Rebuild the character, reassign the points. So basically, if you screw up something, you can't screw up anymore in this game. You can simply spend like, I think, a Dragon Soul and reassign everything, or make a skill legendary and retake the points back. There's a bunch of ways to fix a broken character. While when the game got released for the first time, you had a limited amount of levels and perks, so you didn't, so you couldn't waste them, because otherwise you would probably end up with a screwed character. Well, now it doesn't really matter too much. You can technically level up as much as you want. With this character, I'm probably going to. I haven't planned really a lot of stuff. But I'm probably going to stick around like level 50, something like that, because once you get over that point, it kinda gets boring. I mean, maybe it's just me. I mean, I have a character that is like level 97 or something like that, but I don't know. It kinda, you pretty much can do anything and be good at it, so it kinda gets boring, I guess. So hopefully I want to try to keep this entertaining, so I don't want to end up with a OP character that pretty much wrecks everything, that will probably get boring pretty quickly. So I'm kinda trying to go for a character that must use shenanigans of various kind to get away from pretty much any situation you can get yourself in.
Wait, you there, step forward.
Anyway, since this character was already made, I'm going, basically the game is gonna skip all that select race stuff. That's thanks to that alternate start mode.
Court entry? Captain, what should we do? He's not on the list.
Forget the list, he goes to the block.
Oh, by the way, let me know if the audio of my voice or of the game is okay. I did some testing, sim that pretty much on the same level, so should be fine. Hopefully I'm not going to waste this, let's say, first episode. Speaking of which, I think that I'm going to play all the way up to Riverwood. Then probably gonna stop there for this episode, and then I'm gonna make the others. Also, I don't think they're going to make the whole main questline, at least it's not the first priority. I'm probably running around gathering a bunch of different stuff, and once I get into the, let's say, middle levels, I probably want to try doing some of the unofficial quests, mod quests, that kind of stuff.
Give them their last rites.
respect you much because in like, what it is, 6 years that the game was out, I never managed to like start playing Farscar, Moonpath to Elsewhere, Weirdtooth, all this kind of DLC fan-made mods. And there are a lot of them, so I want to kind of explore all of them, possibly. Or at least most of
my
them.
My ancestors are smiling at me, Imperials. You say the same.
You Imperial bastards!
I hope that you can't hear in the background, but man, my PC is going in meltdown.
It's
so hot right now, and I'm with, like, every window open to get some air. I'm like cooking in this goddamn room.
Here it is again. Did you hear that?
I said, next prisoner.
To the block, prisoner. Nice and easy.
Okay, so we've almost got our controls. Control of our character. So right over the start, I'm going to follow, I think, the Stormcloak guy.
What do you see?
I don't remember the name. I think like Harolf, something like that. And I'm going to follow him. It doesn't really matter which guy you follow, but for me, I can show a couple of stuff better, and you get a couple of advantages when you get to Riverwood that I'd rather use with this kind of character that I'm making.
What is that thing? Could the legends be true?
Okay, so let's try to go over all of this very quickly. By the way, I'm not going to do like, I don't know, speedrunning, that kind of stuff. I'm going to play fairly relaxed, but I want to get over all this boring part. Take the dragon lens, burns the guy, burns the guard, all the stuff, get him stuck. Stepping on poor womans. Okay, so for the Stormcloak guy was this entrance here. Okay, so the difference. If you follow the Imperial, you get an early access to two-handed weapons because Stormcloaks tend to use these, but you only get light armors early on. And then once you get to Riverwood, you get to pick some free blacksmithing stuff, so it's not a bad, cioè it's a fairly useful stuff for like a warrior or something like that. On the other hand, if you follow this guy, getting two-handed weapons early on is a bit harder, but you can get heavy armor early on, so if you want to play some kind of tank, that helps. And once you get to Riverwood, you
looks like we're the only ones who made it.
You don't get to that pick the blacksmithing stuff no for free, although
like
you can still steal
and
you can still steal it.
Of the end times.
It kind of sounds like a pun.
We better get
probably
moving.
My
come
broken
here,
English
is
anyway, so you can get a bit of extra cash, maybe an enchanted ring, that kind of stuff. So that's why I'm following this guy right now. Also, it doesn't really matter as far as the Civil War is concerned,
those
because you can switch side even while you're in the middle of the Civil War questline, so that's irrelevant.
There you go.
Okay, so come on, free
well
my hands.
He won't be needed anymore.
Okay. Let's quickly equip all this stuff. Okay. Remove these.
Alright. Get that armor on. Give that axe a few swings. I'm going to see if
okay,
I can.
Okay, so now it's time
here
to show our like fist trick, and I think that he only works with this guy because he can't get the key to open that door, while the Imperial guy will have that key.
No way to open this from our side.
So now they are the Imperial coming.
Come on, it's the Imperial. Keep moving, cover. Get this gate open. Stormcloaks, filthy traitors.
Yes, kill move. Shit, I killed my own wolf. Okay, so once you kill the captain, you want to get that key, this one, before the Stormcloak guy gets it. So you lose the whole body. And another advantage of following the Stormcloaks is that a lot of the Imperial stuff has a fairly decent value, so you can get some coin once you get in the village. Okay, so let's see. I think that I'm gonna keep the axe. Let's go with like light armor, doesn't really matter what I equip. Pretty much all on the same all the same level, so it's almost irrelevant. Okay, so if I go here, that is where the Imperial came from. There should be some stuff laying around. Some gold, free helmet, bunch of gold. All this other stuff is like useless unless you have some mod where you can like burn the broom. I'm gonna take this. It's not a joke, that is actually something that I need for later, but I'm gonna show that in like I think second, maybe third episode, time to get to the college. Oh, and I was forgetting, so speaking of this character background, it's the background, obviously, that there is the usual part of getting caught on the border, that's obviously. Basically, it's an apprentice mage, another broom, that got the lantern, okay, that's all. It's basically an apprentice mage that got caught at the border while trying to get to Winterhold. So I'm going to focus the playstyle kind of that. So for example, I'm going to try to not use the most like expert or master level spells aside from, let's say, scrolls or staves, I think it's in English, or staffs. But I'm going to focus mainly on like novice, apprentice level spells, some kind of stuff, kind of like a self-imposed handicap, so to speak. Anyway, okay, first trick for new player. So, once you're in this room and you have the key, he can't go in the next phase of the tutorial until you open that door. As long as you're here, he will never turn aggressive, no matter what you do. So, for example, I go into sneak mode.
See if you can unlock that door.
And I get to level up sneak and one-handed. Or for example, I could, you know, slash him, go for example for this and level up blocking. I could go with flames, burn him a little to level up that. So it kinda takes a bit of time, so it's fairly boring. I wouldn't really recommend it too much. What I would recommend would be to do this, because leveling up one-handed and sneak, you can get some fairly easy extra levels early on. On Destruction takes a bit too much, it's kind of boring. Anyway, not gonna do that, kind of trying to show some glitches without abusing too many of them. So let's get out of here. Okay, cabbages. I am using the I need mod, which means that I need to like eat, rest and stuff. Otherwise I take a bunch of malus. So let's see. Okay, a bit better. I think that I can consume this as well. I kinda must be careful because you can get drunk, which is something that I don't want right now. Conjure familiar, okay. So let's get him go in front. Difficulty level, I think that right now I'm playing on I think Adept, like the one right before Master. I'm kinda trying to get a balance with the difficulty level of the game and mods. I'm kinda trying to get a balance between difficulty and a mix of realism, because I played on Legendary before, and it's not particularly fun or challenging really. If you use certain strategies, you pretty much never get hit, so it doesn't matter how much damage the enemy does in Legendary. And the only thing is that you need more hits to kill an enemy, and it kinda gets ridiculous when to kill an enemy you have to turn him into a porcupine with arrows, so it kinda kills immersion, etc. I think that I'm gonna leave that armor a bit too heavy. I need food. So doesn't need that. Wrong menu. What the fuck is in front of me? Probably is this. I have the I think it was called like realistic camera, something like that. Enhanced camera, I think that was the name. It was used for, I don't know which mod was like a requirement for something that I was using, and then I decided to keep it around since I kind of liked the result. Okay, so I think I've got almost everything I need. Some extra food, potions. Okay, I don't think that was a skill book. You usually can notice that by the price. Extra potions. Okay, so I take the baskets. Okay, so I think that by now, like, considering how old the game is, it's like common knowledge what you can do with the baskets, but just in case there are new players, basically if you put this on the head of an NPC and then you can you drop into sneak mode, they pretty much don't see you. It's kind of a weird glitch, but fairly useful when you want to steal some stuff. I don't think that there are the wooden planks here as well. Not yet. Either I missed them or they're not there, so I'm probably gonna pick them up later. They're fairly useful to glitch like through walls and stuff. Not really needed right now, but it comes in hand if you want to get specific weapons. That's maybe for another video to show the stuff. For example, if I want to get the Akaviri sword, I don't remember the English name, but basically it's the Blades Katana. Okay, so here is like the only moment when you can get some two-handed weapons. If you're following the Stormcloaks, basically you want to kill one of these random Stormcloaks, and you can get some two-handed weapon. Let's say you're playing with a Barbarian or something. Okay, so some extra XP. Leveling up said this magic skill is gonna be so annoying.
Hold on, let's go.
I don't think I'm going to take the mace shield, yes. Extra lockpicks, I don't think that there's anything else. Okay, I always like to take this book. Kinda feel appropriate. Okay, this stuff. Let's. Where was it? Steel dagger here. Okay, so lockpicking. I probably should install some mod to make lockpicking less annoying. At this point, is like more of a nuisance than anything. Okay, so the book I don't remember, I think it was Sparks, yes. Okay, so allora. Probably I kinda did that right now. I'm probably gonna slip sometimes between like Italian and English. It's kinda hard to always speak English and not switch over. I kinda try to keep that in mind. Let's see, I want let's see, boots, gloves, okay. Now, another little trick for new players. Technically, these cages are empty, but you can still decide to lockpick them just to get that little extra experience. So it's not really needed for most characters, but for, let's say, you want to play a thief, some kind of rogue, it's a good idea, you get some extra experience. Okay, so the same deal with these, most of them are empty, but I'm almost there with leveling up lockpicking. And there is this one. This one has some gold in it, so it's actually one that I want to open. Of course. Let's switch back to that. Okay, skeletons have obviously the alchemic ingredients, sometimes also a bit of gold. It's not much, like a couple of coins, so in the big scheme of things it's not that relevant, but still. Okay, a couple of skelly here. Okay, come on. Want to be done with this tutorial. I've done this too many times. I'm kinda waiting for them because right now I maybe have some chances, but I'm not gonna take the risk. Okay, so flames, they can take care of this guy. I'm gonna just really jump around. Obviously my aim shit with a weapon. Whatever, burn. Oh, speaking of yes. Yeah, I know, I'm an asshole. Sorry about that. They don't really matter anyway. I probably should like stay in character and not be such an asshole. I'm going to try that after the tutorial, to be a bit more in character and not kill random people just for fun. What I was going to do? Ah, yes. Okay, so the Novi Sud has a magical effect that gives us 13 points of extra magica, while the Robes just extra 50% of magica regeneration. There is one little nice thing about Dude. So if I get in my favorite menu and then I sing this to, let's say, one, I think you can do that even with controllers, but I tried to play with a controller, I prefer a keyboard. Anyway, so, what happens is this. I'm going to use all my magic right now. Then I click the equipper, equip my wood, and I get 30 points of magicka, so I can basically keep doing this as much as I want. It's fairly well known, obviously, to regular players, but it can be helpful for new players, obviously. And it's a really nice trick if you're playing a low-level mage, because the biggest thing with playing a mage during the low levels is that you're going to get without magicka fairly quickly. So this kinda helps, because otherwise you have to rely on weapons. Which is fine at low level, really, it's not that different, but I mean, if you can use extra magicka, it will also help level up a bit faster those magic skills, so I'd rather not use weapons too much. With this character I may use them, because I'm kind of trying to make, as I said, a bit of everything. I don't know if I'm going to like stick with a sword or use daggers later on, we'll see. As I said, there's like a lot of stuff that I have to probably polish about this character. And I fall, obviously. Oh man, I hate... I swear, in this game, if there is one thing that I hate, it's like walking on stairs, bridges, that kind of stuff. Man, I remember when I played Dark Souls, the game was fairly easy. The only thing that killed me was like me making some stupid mistakes with stairs and stuff like that. Damn gravity. Come on.
Let's see where this goes.
Okay, so a random torch right here. This shouldn't be here. I don't know if it's like for alternate start or what, but I'm going to pick it. Torches are fairly useful. Actually, I'm going to add that to the menu as well. With torches you can do some interesting stuff, because I was forgetting, I also have a shield, and that is something that I want as well. Okay, sorry guys, train passing by. Okay, so here there's this little cave with some extra gold, a potion, and a skelly. That's something that new players can miss if they pass by. And I want... man, so much stuff in the favorites. Longbow. Okay, that makes a bit easier to navigate. I think that I should install some mod to change this working animation combo. I'm going to find something later on. Okay, so this is something I like to do with pretty much any class that I try to play. I really shouldn't be doing this if I'm going to play, like, let's say, a warrior, but I like to do it anyway. I think that you can one-shot them, like, even on Legendary. But it's been so much time since the last time that I'm not entirely sure. And doing this makes the next fight a bit easier. So let's get him, go by. So no sneak attack. Okay, let's collect the poison, the eggs. Okay, so let's see. I think that with the spider I probably missed the one, maybe. I'm trying to go over all this really quickly. I don't want to bore you guys, but I'm kinda trying to get as much resources as I can, because I know that I'm kinda going to need them. You can do a lot of fairly... Let's drop this. I'm trying, as I said, to get as much stuff as I can, because it kinda comes in handy once I get to the crafting stations. Alchemy is like the best way to make money in the game, because you basically turn crap into money, let alone when you actually make useful stuff. There are a bunch of potions that I'm probably gonna show like next episode that are fairly useful for starting mages to get extra magicka, and there are a bunch for like starting archers which are actually useful for everyone, because for some weird reason with the marksman potions, the one that boosts archery damage, boost any type of damage that isn't magical.
I'd rather not tangle with her right now. Let's try to sneak by.
Extra. And that was weird. I need to upgrade my Hoverbone. What the fuck I have? That. Yeah, you're probably gonna see me drop stuff randomly fairly often. And I can't carry everything. As I said, I need to upgrade my graphic card. Probably gonna do that sooner or later. Since I don't know how many of you guys know that, but I like most other games. If you know the channel, you probably know that, but just in case. So I'm probably planning on getting most underworld for PC. So there's that. That was a bit too close of what I wanted, but oh well. There should be just a bunch of random weapons, nothing too relevant. I think that I did this. Yes, I leveled up. I'm probably gonna save that, and this is another good tip for new players. Once you level up in Skyrim, you basically, if you add, let's say, less magicka, stamina or health than the maximum amount, you get replenished. It's like a free potion that resets everything. So for example, if you're in the middle of combat and you have low health or low magicka or both, you can level up. It's a bit like immersion killing, but it works. So if you need, you know, some extra health during a fight, you just level up and you save on potions by doing this.
That looks like the way out. Knew it, mate.
Okay, so now I'm going to show another trick that not a lot of the new players know, and I'm kinda over encumbered already. So I'm probably gonna have to drop some stuff, or maybe get here later, I don't know, I'm going to decide later on. Basically, you can... there's this guy, either the Imperial or the Stormcloak, which acts like a bodyguard early on. So, for example, I'm going to get some extra help from him to kill some enemies that would be a bit harder to kill right now, and this is gonna get me some free extra stuff to sell or use for to either sell or in the village or use with this character. And there's the stuff, it's fairly random, so sometimes you get only like steel weapons, sometimes it's a mix of like steel and iron weapons, there's like a bunch of heavy armor, light armor. It's a bit because there is like a guy with one-handed weapon and shield, another guy with two-handed, and a guy that is an archer. So you kinda get a bit of everything and it's randomized. So for example, it you could get in one let's play you could get, let's say, a greatsword from the 200 guy, and in the other maybe it's a warhammer. And figured I'm also gonna pick a fuck ton of flowers. Kind of need these. And I know that I'm going to be so over encumbered. Okay, my PC is kind of like melting right now. Kind of hope that it doesn't die. Okay, so I don't see the guy, but there's a camp there. So what I'm going to do, shoot the arrow, they get angry at me. And just run, and now he gets them and kills them, basically. So I'm just gonna play some support and that's it. So summon that, prepare some magic, basic stuff. Man, with magic weapons I hit more often than not allies rather than enemies. Okay, so extra carrying capacity, this is worth a lot. I'm going to say steel weapon, I'm going to get this later. Let's kill the other guy first. And this poor familiar. Another tip when you're fighting with like a mage or maybe a battle mage character, the basic spell that I'm using is called Flames. Don't use it like a continuous stream, but go like how do you say that in English? You know this. Go hit and run on that on the button. So get it. Quick bursts instead of just a stream. It's gonna do extra damage. Ok, so let's see, arrows, longbows, gun, treasure map, gonna leave something, what can I leave that's fairly heavy? Let's just equip the... where was it? Ok, some extra carrying capacity. So the camp is now is free. I can get some extra bunch of stuff to like disenchant and stuff like that. There is a book for one-handed, some gold. Oh, the wooden plates. This one, there is a bunch of stuff that you can use to actually go through like. Close the doors and stuff like that, but I like the wooden plates. Okay, extra food, some if the sachets open. Okay, some extra stuff. I think that's everything. Let's get to the two bodies. Okay, so a lot of this stuff luckily is fairly light. And I'm over encumbered, so let's see. What was it? This was okay. So that's some weight. And I kinda don't want to drop the bows. I'm trying to keep as much valuable stuff as I can. So I can just sell them later. Sure, let's drop that. That. Let's eat some food. Where was it? Wine. Can I move? No, not yet. Skyrim with the over encumbrance. Yeah, sure, let's drop like a bow. probably gonna have to drop a fairly a lot of them. And then there was the last guy here. Iron boots, the helmet, the mace, the armor. I think that some of this stuff is gonna go, but let's see what I can keep. Not that much stuff, but it is what it is, so Iron Dagger can go. I kinda want to keep some of this stuff, but it's just too heavy. That should be fine. I can kinda come back here later, I don't know if I'm going to do that. And right, there's another thing that I was almost forgetting to say. So to make this a bit more like enjoyable and let's say realistic, as much as realistic can be for a fantasy game, I'm trying to not use the fast travel. So carriages are fine, but fast travel I'm going to try to avoid, just walk or like buy a horse or something like that. Okay, so the stones I'm going to go with a mage stone. Okay. I think that I'm fairly close, so if I start picking too much flowers I'm going to get over encumbered pretty quickly. See, there are so many. This is something that maybe I'm going to do off screen, like going back into the close proximity of the village on the road and gather some extra flowers and stuff. Okay, so flames, I'm going to do actually like this. Fucking flying wolves. I'm not even sure that that wolf died actually. Yes, it did. Over encumbered again. What do I have that is fairly sure? Shit, that was an heavy hit. Man, the gravity effects in Skyrim. Okay, so let's see, I can't get stuff too heavy. So this and this, I'm really like borderline as far as weight is concerned. Okay, so speaking of like tips for new players, if you're playing a mage, as like counterintuitive as it can be, the having a shield is fairly useful, because early on it's not easy to keep like enemy at bay unless you use sneak. So having let's see, let me make some space. What was it like for not boots, shoes? Don't have any. Whatever. As I was saying, so having a shield early on makes it's really helpful because you can just shield bash. This is gonna give you some extra like time. Let's see how much. Okay, I'm going to stop picking up stuff. Like I can't get over encumbered again and again. There is like some treasure there, But I'm going to show that probably in like next episode, because I think that this episode is already long enough as it is. But man, my FPS, my frame rate just dropped right there.
It's a dragon! I saw a dragon!
What? Okay, so let's just go with the usual thing, speak with the woman here. Tell them of the dragon, you do some stuff.
New to Riverwood? If you're looking for... Of course. Here's the key to the house. Oh, what's this all about? What are you doing?
Okay, so let's see. Nothing magic, but whatever. Pretty much everything that I need is just gonna be sold.
A dragon? In Helgen? It can't be. Although... It would explain what I saw earlier, flying down the valley from the south. I thought I must have just been seeing things. I don't know why, but I actually believe you. You've
okay,
things
I'm
just go from
to,
bad
like,
to worse.
Be a bit quicker
the
about
needs to know
this
if there's a dragon loose. Riverwood
I kinda want
defenseless.
To leave this for like new players who
we
don't know what's going on, but... At the same time, it gets kind of boring.
We heard that Ulfric had been
okay, so there is a lot of stuff that I'm probably gonna pick later.
At least now I am.
And right now I'm opening Umbrand again.
Somewhere we can talk.
So I'm just gonna go to the blacksmith and the general trader, sell a bunch of stuff, maybe buy something. I think that I'm going like update you on the start of the new episode on like. A few stuff that I did here, so that later on we can move on Whiterun, and from there I can start to finally picking some of the stuff that I need for this character right here. So for this episode that's all. Hopefully it was like not too terrible, and you know, if you like want to see more episodes, it's the usual thing like subscribe, comment, that kind of stuff. Especially comments, that those kinda help me get an idea of like what you want to get to see and that kind of stuff, so you know. Okay, so for this episode it's all. See you in the next one.